Hi, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going over Power BI Desktop Specs, Part 1, the basics. Before we get to it, remember to like and subscribe, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and even turn on that little alarm bell so you get notified every time I publish new content. Really helps grow the channel. I'd appreciate it quite a bit. All right, let's head on over to it. All right, so you're asking yourself, I'm working in Power BI. Sometimes some of the stuff I'm doing is slow. It doesn't run right. What's the deal? What are the specs that I should be looking for? And more importantly, why do I need to have these specs, right? So the biggest and number one thing that you're looking for when you're working inside of Power BI is you want to have the most memory that you possibly can. Bare minimum, bare bones that we're talking here, is 16 gigs of memory. Anything less than that, and you're going to really struggle with resources between the operating system and Power BI. The reason you're asked, you say, well, 16, that sounds like a lot. Why do I want 16? Or even more, hopefully you get to 32 gigs, is every time you launch a Power BI desktop, what happens behind the scenes is analysis services, a full version of SQL Server analysis services, is spun up in the back end of on your system. You don't even know that it's going on. That stands up, that starts running, and then Power BI gets displayed on top of that. So that's why you're going to see, like, opening a Power BI file is going to take a long time. The more data that you have inside your fact table, the more tables you have, the more stuff that goes into your model, the more that it's going to consume memory as it loads the model and you start to work with it. When you're talking about your desktop, you need to have a lot of memory available for you. And ideally, one of the things you want to look for is you want to look for the fastest memory you can get as well. Number two, the most important thing that you care about is your processor. And for this, you really, really care about the speed of your processor, not the number of cores, okay? Now, the reason that the speed of the processor comes into play and not the number of cores is Power BI is a single-threaded application. Analysis services will just run on, depending upon the a number of users on a model, it'll just really run on one core. So if you're doing development, it's just going to be on a single core. You say, okay, Chris, why do I want it to be fast? It's because the tabular engine, as it runs through this model, that's going to determine how fast all of your Power BI responses are, right? So your processor is going to fly through and, you know, try to do your DAX calculations. Even if, you know, the most complex ones, it's going to run through, it's going to take advantage of that fast processor. Again, there are tools out there when it comes to DAX Studio that you can use to balance and test these things out. But when you're looking at your laptop, you're going to want to make sure that you have the fastest processor that you can find available to you. Okay. Now, when we look at disk space, disk space is another thing that people often talk about when they're coming with a laptop. Like, oh, how big's my hard drive? What do we got to do here? It doesn't matter. Get out of here. Don't worry about the disk space. That plays almost no. You don't care about that at all. Okay, disk space is where you'll save your PBIX files there. Hopefully, you're checking those out into OneDrive, or you're saving them into some sort of like. Out onto Git or someplace that's backed up by your corporation. But for the most part, the size of your hard drive, that's inconsequential. You shouldn't be counting on, you know, storing data in PBIX files. It's really a kind of a bad plan. Do not count on that if you're going to be doing that, okay? You can have a real bad time with that. So don't worry about your hard drive. That's not going to be important for you, okay? So we're going to go out there. We're going to make some recommendations here. Minimum, if you're working inside Power BI, 16 gigs of memory. Ideally, you're going to have 32 gigs or more of memory in your system. when you're talking about your processor, you want to have a minimum of a Ryzen 5 or an i5 processor from Intel. Ideally, in both cases, you're either going to be running a Ryzen 7 or an i7 processor from Intel. So hopefully Team Red, you'll go the AMD route, but you know, hey, if you're Team Blue and you go the Intel, that's, you know, that's your choice. Actually, I use both. I'm lean towards Team Red, but I understand, and I use Intel as well. All right. Well, thank you very much for joining me running through these desktop specs. Remember, if you're working in Power BI, you want your stuff to go really fast, make sure you've got a fast computer with plenty of memory and a fast processor. That's really going to make sure that you have a good time. All right. If you like the content, hit the like button, hit subscribe, turn that alarm bell. Really appreciate it. If you really like the content, you want to buy me a coffee, or you're just narcissistic, you know, you don't care about buying me a coffee, and you're just like, I want to get my hands on some of those cool freaking Power BI stickers that you got here, because I got some really cool stickers. You buy me a coffee, I'll send you a thank you letter. Inside there, I'll toss in a bunch of stickers. You'll be good to go. You really like the stuff. You really like the Kratos BI data gods and the stuff that's going on. Go ahead, click on that merch link down below. Get yourself a data god or goddess t-shirt. Sport those at the next conference. You'll be looking real nice there, Clark, real nice. Thanks for watching Desktop Specs and Power BI Part 1. I talked through the basics of Power BI and why you might need that. In Part 2, I'm going to be going over the build that I use, so you know that I'm not just, you know, blowing smoke up your butt. All right. Thanks, everybody. Have a good one. Peace.